Good morning, Bearcats. I'm Caleb.
And I'm Dom.
Today is Friday, February 23rd, and this is Bearcat News.
Today's lunch will be mashed potatoes, baked beans, assorted fruit, with the choice of entree being barbecue with bun, beefy burrito, roasted chicken with roll, PB&J pack, or a chef's salad.
As we close out Random Acts of Kindness Week, HOSA wants to remind all Bearcats to be kind to everyone every single day. We'll be recognizing Rare Disease Day on Leap Day, which is next Thursday. Please drop by the main office window and help color in the big zebra. Zebras, stripes, and the colors pink, blue, green, and purple are used to represent rare diseases.
Are you in need of volunteer hours? Interact Club has multiple opportunities for students to earn those hours. Students can volunteer to wrap books for elementary students in our area. Students can volunteer at the Bristol, Virginia Little League umpiring, assisting in concessions, bookkeeping, announcing, and field maintenance. Students can volunteer at Children's Inc. to help children with homework and organizing activities and games. Students can volunteer with the upcoming prom dress sale at the YWCA, where they have an opportunity to earn a free prom dress. Students can volunteer at a local health care facility to visit with elderly patients and assist the nurse or social worker. Students can volunteer with a clerical worker at Abuse Alternatives. Please see Ms. Cox if you are interested in any of these opportunities.
Seniors, don't forget to buy a senior ad in this year's yearbook. Prices are $275 for a full page, $175 for half a page, $125 for a quarter of a page, or $65 for an eighth of a page.
Also, if you would like to share any pictures you take throughout the school year to be possibly selected to be used in the yearbook, go to hjeshare.com and type in VHS Bearcats to select Virginia High School. You may see your picture in the 2023-2024 yearbook.
Now, let's go to a segment about Black History Month.
Today, we have an amazing story to share with you all.
That's right. Today, we're diving into the fascinating life of John Barry Meacham.
He's not just your ordinary historical figure. Meacham was a true trailblazer, making a big impact in his community.
Absolutely. And guess what? We're going to take you on a journey through his extraordinary life, full of twists and turns.
All right, let's kick things off. John Barry Meacham was born into slavery way back in 1789.
But here's the thing. Despite facing a lot of challenges, Meacham didn't let events in his life define him. Nope.
He was determined to break free from the chains of slavery, quite literally. So he worked hard and saved up enough money to buy his freedom and his father's too. Talk about determination.
Oh, absolutely. And then he moved to Kentucky, got married, and started a family. But you know what? His journey was just getting started.
That's right. In 1815, Meacham packed his bags and headed to St. Louis, a bustling river town.
And let me tell you, he wasted no time making a name for himself there. With his skills in carpentry, he found plenty of opportunities.
It wasn't long before he opened up his own shop. Talk about turning dreams into reality.
But you know what really sets Meacham apart? It's not just his carpentry skills, but his heart for his community.
Meacham was deeply religious, and he wanted to spread hope and faith among his fellow African Americans.
He went on to establish the first African Baptist church. Now that's dedication.
And get this, he didn't stop there. He also opened up a school in the basement of his church, teaching black men, women, and children how to read and write.
Meacham faced a lot of resistance, especially from those who didn't believe in educating black people.
But you know what they say. Where there's a will, there's a way. And Meacham found a way around those obstacles.
Oh, you bet. When laws were passed to prevent black education, Meacham didn't give up. Nope, he took his school to the Mississippi River, creating what became known as the Floating School.
Talk about innovation. And you know what's even more amazing? Some of his students went on to do incredible things, like James Milton Turner, a prominent civil rights leader.
Meacham wasn't just about helping individuals. He was all about paving the way for freedom and self-reliance.
Exactly. He even bought slaves from their masters, teaching them valuable skills and preparing them for life after slavery.
And you know what's truly remarkable? Meacham's legacy lives on, inspiring generations to stand up for what's right.
So, there you have it, folks. The incredible story of John Barry Meacham, a man who defied the odds and made a lasting impact on his...
Now, let's take a look at the upcoming Bearcat events.
Today and Saturday, Girls Regional Basketball Tournament will take place at UVA Wise.
Also, today and tomorrow, the indoor track teams will travel to Liberty University.
And as well today and tomorrow, Kelsey Garman and Justin Mai will travel to the all-VA band and orchestra auditions at James Madison University. They qualified at the district level to audition for the state level.
And finally, we want to remind you that all of the upcoming winter break that will take place on the 1st through 4th of March.
That's your Bearcat News for Thursday. We hope you all have a great day.
It's Friday. And stay classy, Bearcats.